Lijep pozdrav, dragi moji, drage moji, dobrodošli u novu lekciju vašeg konverzacijskog engleskog. U današnjoj lekciji učimo novo vrijeme, takozvani past continuous. Ne trebate sada da budete prepadnuti, jel, past continuous, šta je sada to? Vrlo je lagano. Ukoliko ste prešli lekciju koju smo obradili present continuous, dakle vrijeme koje koristimo za radnju koja traje sada, dakle u ovom trenutku dok govorimo, dok vi gledate ovaj video, onda ćete vrlo lako shvatiti da past continuous nije ništa drugo već to, samo stavljeno u prošlo vrijeme. Dakle, kao što nam naziv present continuous kaže da se nešto dešava u sadašnjosti, present, da nešto traje, continuum, tako i past continuous nam kaže da se nešto dešavalo u prošlosti, past, i dakle trajalo je, continuum. Kako ćemo tvoriti to vrijeme? Vrlo lako. Kao što smo present continuous stvorili od sadašnjeg vremena glagola to be, a to su, sjetit ćemo se, na oblici am, is, are, tako ćemo past continuous tvoriti od pomoćnog glagola to be za prošlo vrijeme koje smo naučili u prošloj lekciji, a to su one oblici was i were. Kod continuous oblika, dakle onog oblika gdje na glavni glagol dodajemo nastavak ing, neće biti nikakvih promjena. Pa da vidimo sada kako će to izgledati na primjerima. Prva rečenica koju prevodimo, što radiš, dakle što radiš sada. Riječ je dakle o present continuous vremenu. Što prevodimo sa what? Dakle, what are you doing? What are you doing? Ovo sada ne moramo prevoditi jer se to podrazumijeva. Šta si radio jučer u 8 ujutro? Dakle, rečenica će biti ista kao ova prethodna, samo što ćemo s ovo are imati oblik za prošlo vrijeme, za you, za drugo lice jednine, a to je were. Pa ćemo da kažemo, what were you doing? What were you doing at 8 a.m. yesterday? What were you doing at 8 a.m. yesterday? Dakle, opet imamo određenu tačku u prošlosti kada je se nešto dešavalo, kada je nešto trajalo. Mi do kraja ove današnje lekcije nećemo upotrebljavati u vremensku oznaku jer bi nam oduzelo puno vremena. Možda ćemo samo spomenuti onako dok budemo govorili o tim rečenicama. Doručkovao sam. Doručkovat se kaže have breakfast. Dakle, I was, prošlo vrijeme glagola to be, I was having, sjećamo se da je glagol have, onaj glagol koji je završao na e, pa se to e izbacuje kada dodajemo nastavak ing. Dakle, I was having breakfast. I was having breakfast. Vozila sam djecu u školu, čiju djecu, vjerojatno svoju. Dakle, I was, voziti se kaže drive, opet glagol koji završava na e, dakle odbijamo to e. I was driving, čiju djecu, moju djecu, my kids to school. I was driving my kids to school. Tuširala sam se. Tuširati prevodimo s izrazom have a shower, dakle opet taj glagol have. I was having a shower. I was having a shower. Dakle, past, u prošlom vremenu glagol to be was, i continuous, glagol have sa nastavkom ing. Past, continuous. Vidite kako nam imena u engleskom jeziku tih vremena govore kako tvorimo ta vremena. Surfala sam na netu. Surf the internet. Pa ćemo reći I was surfing, možemo samo reći net, ne moramo reći internet. Dakle, I was surfing the net. Čitao sam vijesti online. I was reading news online. I was reading news online. Jedeš doručak, zar ne? Možda zvuči onako clumsy, ali doručkuješ, zar ne, je možda ok, ali kad budemo to stavili u prošlo vrijeme, doručkovao si. To kod nas već implicira da je radnja završena. Ja mislim da je mnogo bolji prevod jeo si doručak u to neko vrijeme u prošlosti. Dakle, radnja tog jela je trajala. Jedeš doručak, zar ne? Dakle, sada, you are having breakfast. Dakle, ne eating breakfast, već having breakfast. You are having breakfast, zar ne? Izjavna rečenica you are, dakle, u ovom zar ne imamo odrečni oblik. Aren't you? Aren't you? You are having breakfast, aren't you? Dakle, sada u ovom trenutku to govorimo. U nekoj tačci u prošlosti, recimo jučer u 8 sati, yesterday at 8 o'clock, jeo si doručak. You were having breakfast, zar ne? Što ćemo sada sa ovom zar ne? Naravno, izjavna rečenica were, dakle, učimo ti odrečni oblik. Weren't you? Weren't you? You were having breakfast, weren't you? Nisi jeo doručak, zar ne? Odrečni oblik. You weren't having breakfast. Were you? Were you? Dakle, obični oblik weren't. Ovdje imamo izjavni oblik were, bez not. You weren't having breakfast. Were you? Jesi li jeo doručak? Jesno, pitanje obično. Were you having breakfast? Were you having breakfast? Da jesam ili ne nisam. Yes, I was ili ne nisam. No, I wasn't. Yes, I was. No, I wasn't. Zar nisi jeo doručak? Evo, ovo odlično pitanje koje pravimo samo što ćemo na ovo prethodno. Were you having breakfast? Na word dodati not. Pa ćemo da kažemo. Weren't you having breakfast? Weren't you having breakfast? Što on radi? Dakle, što on sada radi? What is he doing? What is he doing? On vozi djecu u školu. Rekli smo voziti drive. Moramo njegovu djecu u školu. He is driving. Nemojte zaboraviti izbaciti e. Driving čiju djecu? Svoju, vjerojatno. His kids to school. He is driving his kids to school. Šta je on radio jučer nekad? Recimo u isto vrijeme. What, naravno prošlo vrijeme, was he doing? What was he doing? Dakle, vidite, jedna razlika je u ovom is i was. Dakle, present continuous, glagol be u sadašnjem vremenu, past continuous, glagol be u prošlom vremenu. Sve ostalo je isto. On je vozio djecu u školu. He was driving his kids to school. He was driving his kids to school. Da li je on vozio djecu u školu? Znamo da samo pravimo inverziju. Mijenjamo mjesto pomoćnom glagolu was i subjektu he. Pa kažemo, was he driving his kids to school? Was he driving his kids to school? Da, jeste ili ne, nije. Yes, he was. Or, no, he wasn't. Yes, he was. Or, no, he wasn't. On se nije tuširao. Tuširati kažemo have a shower. He wasn't having a shower. Znamo opet, pošto je ovdje odrečni oblik wasn't, ovdje će biti to samo was bez not. Was he? He wasn't having a shower. Was he? On je još uvijek spavao, zar ne? He was, još uvijek ćemo prevesti sa still, he was still sleeping Wasn't he? He was still sleeping, wasn't he? Što ona radi? Kada? Sada. Dakle, present continuous. What is she doing? What is she doing? Ona priprema doručak. She is making breakfast. She is making breakfast. Dakle, jesti doručak, have breakfast, praviti doručak, make breakfast. She is making breakfast. Što je ona radila? Mi znamo da ćemo samo umjesto ovoga is staviti was, pa ćemo reći. What was she doing? What was she doing at 8 o'clock yesterday? Ona je pripremala doručak. She was making breakfast. She was making breakfast. Da li ona pravila pripremala ručak? Dakle, samo ćemo zamijeniti mjesto was i she, pa ćemo da kažemo. Was she making breakfast? Was she making breakfast? Da, jeste ili ne, nije. Yes, she was, or no, she wasn't. Yes, she was, or no, she wasn't. Zar ona nije vozila djecu u školu? Zar ona nije? Dakle, samo na was she dodajemo to not između. Dakle, wasn't she voziti djecu, driving. E sada, pošto riječ ona, bit će her kids, dakle malo prije bio on, pa je bilo his kids, a sada pošto je ona, bit će her kids. Wasn't she driving her kids to school? Wasn't she driving her kids to school? Pada kiša. Evo, ona je oblik sa it. It is raining. It is raining. Padala je kiša, naravno samo ćemo umjesto ovo is staviti was, pa ćemo da kažemo it was raining. It was raining. Ok. Padala je kiša, zar ne? It was raining, wasn't it? It was raining, wasn't it? Dakle, izjavni oblik, odrični oblik. Okay. Nije padala kiša, zar ne? It wasn't raining, was it? Dakle, ovu intonaciju malo poviste. It wasn't raining, was it? Ili u prethodnom primjeru. It was raining, wasn't it? It was raining, wasn't it? It wasn't raining, was it? Zar nije padala kiša? Wasn't it raining? Recimo, last night, sinoć. Wasn't it raining? Što radite sada? What are you doing? What are you doing? Perimo suđe. Wash the dishes. We are washing the dishes. We are washing the dishes. Šta ste vi radili? Dakle, samo mjesto are stavljamo koji oblik? Were. What were you doing? What were you doing? Prali smo suđe. Dakle, umjesto we are washing the dishes, sad ćemo reći we were washing the dishes. We were washing the dishes. We were washing the dishes. Nismo gledali TV. Znamo da se gledati TV, kaže watch TV. We weren't watching TV. We weren't watching TV. Jeli ste doručak? Rekli smo se kaže have breakfast. You were having breakfast, weren't you? You were having breakfast, weren't you? Mislim da je do sada sasvim postalo jasno da su oblici za drugo lice jednine i množine isti. Dakle, you, bila se vraća jednoj osobi ili ima njih više. Dakle, you were having breakfast, weren't you? Da li ste jeli doručak? Were you having breakfast? Were you having breakfast? Da, jesmo ili ne, nismo. Yes, we were. Or, no, we weren't. Yes, we were. Or, no, we weren't. Zar niste vodili djecu u školu? Weren't you voditi djecu? Sad umjesto drive imamo voditi. U tom slučaju koristimo glagol take. Dakle, weren't you taking your kids, svoju djecu? Weren't you taking your kids to school? Weren't you taking your kids to school? Niste vodili djecu u školu, zar ne? You weren't taking your kids to school. Were you? Tako je. Were you? You weren't taking your kids to school. Were you? Još uvijek ste spavali, zar ne? You were, rekli smo još uvijek, still, you were still sleeping. Weren't you? You were still sleeping, weren't you? Što oni rade? Evo treće lice jednine. What are they doing? What are they doing? Oni se spremaju za školu. Get ready for school. Spremaju se za školu. Dakle, they are getting ready for school. They are getting ready for school. Dakle, present continuous, pomoćni glagol bi u prezentu, u continuous obliku, glavni glagol. Ovdje imate uduplavanje ovog zadnjeg konsonanta i to je specifično za ove kratke glagole, dakle, koji se sastoji od suglasnika, samoglasnika, suglasnika, kao što je get, dakle, get. Uglavnom je riječ o tri slova, nekad imamo i više, kao što recimo kod swim se to isto dešava, dakle samo trebate postepeno pamtiti, ne morate to sad, ne morate se pratiti listu pa kod kojih se to dešava, kako budemo radili tako to i pamtite. Dakle, they are getting ready for school. Šta su oni radili? What were they doing at 8 a.m. yesterday? Spremali su se za školu, dakle samo ću umjesto ovoga are staviti koji oblik? Were, tako je. Dakle, they were getting ready for school. They were getting ready for school. Dakle, opet were i ne zaboravite duplo t. Da li su se oni spremali za posao? Were they getting ready for posao, work. Were they getting ready for work? Oni su se spremali za posao, zar ne? They were getting ready for work. Weren't they? Weren't they? They were getting ready for work. Weren't they? Da, jesu ili ne, nisu. Yes, they were. Or, no, they weren't. Yes, they were. No, they weren't. Oni se nisu spremali za zabavu. Zar ne? They weren't getting ready for the party. Were they? Dakle, mislim neku određenu party, zato je ovo the party. They weren't getting ready for the party, were they? Zar oni nisu gledali film? Weren't they watching a movie? Or weren't they watching a film? Kako god želite, koja god vam je riječ draža. Weren't they watching a film? Weren't they watching a movie? I eto, time smo došli do kraja još jedne lekcije na ovom kanalu. Ono što vam ja uvijek napominjem je najprije da lekciju uvijek skinete sebi iz Facebook grupe MyGateDeutsch, sami pokušate to prevesti, pa tek onda prođete kroz ovu lekciju da vidite koliko ste toga znali da uradite. Naravno, ukoliko već imate neko predznanje, ukoliko ga nemate, onda najbolje oslušate lekciju, pokušate sami da uradite vježbe i tek onda opet pustite klip i preslušati i pregledati da li ste sve tačno preveli. Kao što je to već i običaj, ja vas pozivam da zapratite kanal ukoliko to još uvijek niste naučili. Meni je drago što broj pretplatnika polako, ali sigurno raste i na ovom kanalu, na kanalu za engleski jezik. Nadam se da će vas biti još više, pa da ćemo moći da snimamo još više videa. Ukoliko imate neke sugestije za neki sadržaj koji bi se mogao naći na ovom kanalu, svakako mi to napišite u komentarima ili mi pišite na email adresu koju vidite na dnu ekrana. Toliko za sada. Ja vas sve lijepo pozdravljam i vidimo se uskoro.